Hello students, in this session we are going to study about standard temperature and pressure conditions followed by molar volume. Right, for any experimental observation we need certain set of conditions like temperature, pressure, etc. Even volume also, at these set of conditions what will be the volume occupied by particular content of gas, like 1 mole of a gas, like that. So about these things we are going to study now, and then we'll discuss about the numericals also followed by. Right, now our topic is standard temperature and pressure conditions. Okay, earlier standard temperature and pressure condition were taken as temperature and pressure. Earlier standard temperature was taken as 0 degree Celsius or 273.15 Kelvin. You know the conversion of degree Celsius to Kelvin scale, right? Degree Celsius plus 273.15, isn't it? Either this or this, you have to remember. And pressure earlier was taken as 1 atmospheric pressure. Was taken as 1 atmospheric pressure, right? This was earlier scale. Now IUPAC modified these values. You know the full form of IUPAC, International Union for Pure and Applied Chemistry, according to which the modified values of standard temperature and pressure are 0 degree Celsius or 273.15 Kelvin temperature and 1 bar pressure. 1 bar pressure. We have to remember these values, and we are going to study about the conversion of this atmosphere to bar, vice versa, etc. And we have another scale. These two comes under STP conditions, earlier and now present STP conditions. Okay, we have another set of conditions that is called as normal temperature and pressure conditions. Normal temperature and pressure conditions, according to which 20 degree Celsius or 20 plus 273, 293.15, 20 degree Celsius or 293.15 Kelvin temperature and 1 atmospheric pressure. Atmosphere is the unit of pressure, right? 1 atmospheric pressure. So this set of conditions are taken as NTP conditions. Do remember these values: 20 degree Celsius or 293.15 Kelvin and 1 atmospheric pressure. We have another set of conditions, namely, that is standard ambient temperature and pressure conditions. Standard ambient temperature and pressure conditions, which is 25 degree Celsius or 298.15 Kelvin. If you add 273 to this, it will be 298, I think. Yes, and 1 bar pressure. So better you remember all these values. Usually reference books, as they are printing these publications from years onwards, most of the books still they are following STP, means 1 atmosphere and 0 degree Celsius only. But according to NCRT, means IUPAC was followed by NCRT, according to IUPAC scale or NCRT book, textbook, these two values must be memorized. Understood? We have to remember these values. That's why they are highlighted. See? You got it? Now, our next concept is molar volume. Molar volume means, the word itself gives us the data. Molar volume means volume occupied by, yes, 1 mole of any substance at STP, of course gaseous substance, volume occupied by 1 mole of any gas at STP. What is that? Volume occupied by 1 mole of any gas at STP usually is called as molar volume. Understood? Means in general we consider this calculation of gaseous substances only. That's why that is given as a definition. Of course, day by day updates are quite common. For time being, you learn this one. What's meant by molar volume? Volume occupied by, yes, volume occupied by 1 mole of any substance at STP. Now I understood your doubt. See, molar volume. Molar volume means, what's that? Volume occupied by one mole of any gaseous substance or any gas at STP. Usually we follow STP conditions. STP means again, two values are coming. These STP conditions are IUPAC STP conditions, right? That's why volume occupied by one mole of any gas at old STP conditions will be 22.4 liters. Sir, how you calculated this value, you may get a doubt. We are going to learn everything in detail in the coming lessons. You might have learned the equation PV equals to NRT. Have you learned? PV equals to NRT. So, from this, V is equals to NRT by P. This is what we have to substitute. See, number of moles, 1 mole. R is universal gas constant. T is absolute temperature, P is pressure. By substituting these values, we are getting, we can calculate volume. Understood? So, at old STP conditions, molar volume will be taken as 22.4 liters. In many publications, they are printing these values only. So, by looking at the value, we can easily predict whether they are following this set or IUPAC set of STP conditions. There is no need to get confused. We can easily assess which scale they are following. If you follow IUPAC conditions of STP and calculate the volume, it will be 22.67, approximately taken as 22.7 liters. So, what is molar volume at STP according to IUPAC scale? 22.7 liters. According to old scale, it is 22.4 liters. Sir, which one we have to follow? We have to follow 22.7 as per NCRT. But while solving questions in some reference books, you might have come across or you may have to come across 22.4 liters. Don't worry about that. Be aware of both the values. This is according to old STP conditions. This is according to new STP that is given by IUPAC. Understood? Now, when it comes to NTP conditions and calculate the same, nearly 24.03 liters will be the molar volume. At NTP, molar volume value is 24.03 liters and standard ambient temperature and pressure conditions according to which molar volume will be 24.7 liters. Of course, 24.67 will come, rounded value 24.7 liters. So, we studied two terms. Here, we studied two terms. STP conditions and molar volume. What are STP conditions? What are STP conditions? Standard temperature and pressure conditions are called as STP conditions. Old STP conditions are 0 degree Celsius temperature and 1 atmospheric pressure. IUPAC changed these values according to which standard temperature is 0 degrees, it is the same, and standard pressure is 1 bar. Got it? And there is one more scale followed by another set of people. NTP conditions, depending on the requirement it is, NTP conditions, okay, normal temperature and pressure conditions, according to which 20 degrees Celsius is the standard temperature, normal temperature, and pressure is 1 atmosphere. For standard ambient temperature and pressure conditions, 25 degrees Celsius is the value and 1 bar is the pressure. Got it? Now, the next term is molar volume. Molar volume means volume occupied by 1 mole of any substance at STP. Usually at STP we follow. At NTP its value is what? We can calculate. I had given just now PV equal to NRT, ideal gas equation. Right? Now, molar volume is volume occupied by 1 mole of any gaseous substance at given conditions. At old STP conditions, molar volume is 22.4 liters. At new STP conditions set given by IUPAC, it was given by IUPAC as 22.7 liters. And NTP volume is 24.03 liters. And standard ambient temperature and pressure volume is 24.7 liters. For competitive exam's sake, you have to remember all these conditions. Even though it's not specified in NCRT completely, NCRT has specified only IUPAC. That is a must, compulsory. Along with this, even these three data also you have to remember. Now, let us go through some set of numericals based on these values. Understood? See. Now you see, small question of this. Calculate the number of molecules, number of moles we will see first. Number of moles of substance of a gaseous substance, whose volume is, whose volume is 22.4 liters at STP. Whose volume is 22.4 liters at STP. So just now we studied molar volume means volume occupied by one mole of any gas at STP. So according to that condition, 22.4 liters volume is occupied by one mole, etc. Suppose the same question is given in a different way. Calculate number of moles of a gas whose volume is 11.2 liters at STP. Whose volume is 11.2 liters at STP. There are two ways to solve this question. One is formula method, other one is comparative, relative comparison method. Like, as 22.4 liters is occupied by one mole of any gas at STP, then 11.2 liters will be occupied by how many moles? Crisscross. 11.2 by 22.4, it is 0.5 moles. 0.5 moles. If you know how to compare in this way, well and good, you can proceed. Otherwise, one shortcut or method to remember is given volume by STP volume gives us number of moles. Given volume by STP volume gives us number of moles. So, now number of moles of the substance can be calculated as given volume is 11.2, STP volume is 22.4, it is 0.5. Means this is a conceptual approach. This is a direct method to remember. Understood? So, they may ask the same concept in different ways. For example, the question is, calculate number of particles, the number of molecules of CO2 presenting 16.8 liters volume. 16.8 liters volume. So, even for this also, we have different logics, of course. Okay, now you see. According to the concept we studied, what is molar volume? Volume occupied by one mole of any gas at STP, right? At STP, 22.4 liters volume is occupied by one mole. 22.4 liters is occupied by 1 mole. What are the number of particles present in 1 mole? Number of molecules present in 1 mole? Avogadro number of molecules. So, directly we can link. At STP, 22.4 liters volume is occupied by Avogadro number of molecules. Then, 16.8 liters will be occupied by how many number of molecules? That's it. It depends on our logic. Okay. Method of approach depends on our logic. One may do in a more simpler method. This is one of the methods. Right. So, then 16.8 liters volume will be occupied by how many molecules? Crisscross. 16.8 by 22.4 into Avogadro number of molecules. That's it. We have to simplify this value. That simplification depends. Yes. Sometimes they may give the options in the same way. Got it. Now, there is another model of question for this. See, 1.5 moles of a gas at STP, 1.5 moles of a gas at STP before going through this, better we discuss one more numerical method. Right. Volume occupied by 1 mole of, you take always, why to take 1 mole? 0.5 moles of O2 gas at STP is, first option will be 11.2 liters, second option will be 22.4 liters, third one will be 16.8 liters, fourth one is 44.8 liters. Volume occupied by 0.5 moles of oxygen gas, some gas, okay, at STP is, this will be the option. Now you will get a doubt, sir, they are following old STP or new STP? The same question they may give in this way, see. Volume occupied by 0.5 moles of O2 gas at STP is, first option will be 11.35 liters, second option will be 22.7 liters, third one will be some 1.35 liters, 1.135 liters. And fourth option will be, can't be predicted or cannot be predicted. Now, what will be your answer from this? See, the same question, here and there, same lines, volume occupied by half mole of oxygen gas at STP, half mole of oxygen gas at STP. Here, see, 22.4 half value is given, into 3 by 4 value is given, into 2 value is given. Here, 22.7 or its half or its by or 20th value, like that. So, they may give options either related to 22.4 or relating to 22.7. They won't give mixed. You need not worry. Understood? If it is given both, this option and 22.7 both are given, you have to give preference to NCERT. Excellent. Right? Now, let us answer this question. Volume occupied by half mole of oxygen gas. You know that 1 mole of any gas at STP occupy 22.4 liters according to old standard. Then half mole of oxygen gas occupy 11.2 liters. Half. That's it. So what's the answer? When it comes to this question, volume occupied by half mole of oxygen gas at STP according to new IUPAC condition, 1 mole of oxygen gas according to new IUPAC condition occupies 22.7 liters, then half mole of oxygen gas occupy 11.35 liters. So where is that? This one. So in this way, by looking at the options, in which mode they had given, old pattern of STP or IUPAC pattern of STP. Observing this, you have to proceed. Got it? Now, there is one more concept here. That is gram molar volume. GMV. Sir, earlier we studied molar volume. This is gram molar volume. Why different terms? See, the word itself shows the difference. Of course, final value is same, but different presentation. What is molar volume? Volume occupied by 1 mole of any gas at STP, right? Here, the difference is volume occupied by 1 gram molecular mass of any substance at STP. That's it. See the mode of presentation. Earlier, For molar volume, what's given here? For molar volume, what volume occupied by 1 mole of any gas? Now, for gram molar volume, 1 gram molecular mass of any gas. We have studied already. 1 gram molecular mass means mass of 1 mole of a substance. 1 gram molecular mass means mass of 1 mole of a substance. So both are same. That is in terms of mole. This is in terms of gram molecular mass. Both values are similar. What were the values we studied earlier? 22.4 for old STP. Yes, we have to recollect. 22.7 for new STP IUPAC. 24.03 for NTP. Yes, and 24.7 approximately for standard ambient and temperature and pressure conditions. Got it? So this is the, and the term, of course, the same value it follows. Now, our next concept is methods of expressing concentration. Methods of expressing concentration. Another important concept in stoichiometry, of course, basic concepts of chemistry. Again, we are going to study this in second year also under the topic solutions and colligative properties. If you become perfect in this now, then second year you can feel that ease of solving questions, right? So concentration is nothing but what? Amount of substance present in unit volume. What's meant by concentration? Amount of substance present per unit volume. In how many ways we can express this amount per unit volume? That's nothing but methods of expressing concentration. We have so many methods, of course, mass per percent, mass fraction, mass percent, volume fraction, volume percent, etc. But most important methods are molarity, which is given with a capital M. Next one is normality, capital N. Third one is molality, small m. Molality, small m. And fourth one is mole fraction, mole fraction given with the symbol psi. Okay. And the fifth one is parts per million, parts per million. Sixth one is percent free SO3 in oleum, percent free SO3 in oleum. And seventh one is volume strength of H2O2. This is used for expressing the concentration of hydrogen peroxide. And still there are so many other methods, but not required for JEE or NEET level. Okay. Now, better we learn these methods of expressing concentration for as per our syllabus limitation, right? And now about this, we are going to continue in our next session. Yes. Hope you followed all these topics. And for molarity followed by normality, we have to recap the concept of equivalent mass. Without equivalent mass concept, we cannot learn this one. So, for doing normality based numericals, equivalent mass concept must be repeated once. Okay. So, by the next class, every one of you must study this equivalent mass. First 4-5 sessions we studied, I think, equivalent mass only. Now it helps you. Okay. Actually, after molarity, we have to discuss equivalent mass. But for this, for our convenience, I started with equivalent mass. Now everyone have learnt equivalent mass. Go through that once again. Everyone without fail, go through this equivalent mass concept. Whatever the first 3-4 sessions we have noticed, we have discussed, then normality will be very, very easy for you. Okay. So we'll continue this session, these topics in our next session, right?